What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 52 of the Ultimate Let's Play Pokemon Brilliant Diamond. And last time I mentioned I was going to be doing some grinding to prepare for the Elite Four, and I did about a little over 3 hours worth of grinding, and I've got my Pokemon to a level I think is going to be able to handle the final challenges of the main storyline. And I've also decided on the six Pokemon I'm going to bring to the Elite Four. I'm going to show you them right now. Weavile, Roserade, Gyarados, Garchomp, Crobat, and Infernape, all at level 60 or higher. I've also adjusted a few of their movesets and given them items here. I'll just go over what I've done with them real quick. Weavile has the black glasses to power up his dark attacks, or her dark attacks. It's a female Weavile. She learned Night Slash on her own, got rid of Beat Up, and I taught her X Scissor, which replaced her Home Claws attack. With Roserade, I taught her Shadow Ball and replaced her old Stun Spore. She also has the Big Root, which will increase the amount of HP that her Giga Drain will recover for her. Gyarados gave the Wacken Berry in case he gets hit by an electric attack. Knows Ice Beam and Bulldoze. I got rid of Hurricane and Dragon Dance. I think this is going to be better suited. And Bulldoze is to counter any pesky electric types that might come our way. With Garchomp, there's one move I do want to teach it. It's a move called Brick Break. I have to actually go to another area that I passed up a while back to retrieve the TM for that, but I did teach it. I taught it Rock Slide, which replaced Crunch, and it also has the Dragon Fang, which will boost its Dragon Claw. Crobat still has the Poison Barb to increase his poison moves. Did I teach it anything? No, I did not. Its moveset remains the same, as does Infernape. And Infernape has the Citrus Berry, just in case worse comes worse. So that's what I've done with the team. So, like, excuse me. Take a swig of water real quick. Like I mentioned, there's an item I want to get, but I'm going to have to venture back into an old area that I haven't been to in a while to retrieve it. So, what I'm going to do, I'm going to head all the way back to Orberg City. Thank you, Star Raptor, for the lift. And I should have a few Max Repels on it, because there's an area, now that we have a Surf, I think, that we can explore Orberg Gate in full. Now, the Pokemon there are probably going to be nothing of concern, so I'm just going to go ahead and put my Max Repel on so I don't have to deal with any pesky wild Pokemon. I don't know if there are any trainers down there or how tough they are, if there is one. But yeah, I got 20 Max Repels, so I'll go in and I'm going to head up to this northern spot, which we couldn't get to without Rock Smash, which we were able to explore a little bit of it, but since we didn't have Surf at the time, the rest of it was kind of off limits. So, I mean, I recovered everything on this side, I believe. But now I can surf and can venture a bit further on into the dungeon here. I don't think this is a very big area to explore, but there are a couple items that are definitely worthwhile getting here. And if I go up here, here's one of them. And it's the TM I'm looking for. It's TM31 Brick Break. It's a fighting type move that will actually break Light Screen or Reflect, and I'm going to be teaching this to Garchomp. And I'm going to get rid of Dig. I think one ground move's enough, and this is going to really expand the move pool of my Dragon type. Help it come across, and help it counter any Ice types it may come across here. Alright, so anyway, it looks like we have one trainer to deal with and two items to pick up. So let's deal with this guy first. I'm a veteran, yes, but don't you dare treat me like a senior citizen. Alright, well, let's see what Pokemon this guy brings to battle here. Veteran Grant. He's only got three Pokemon. I'm going to start off with a Riolu. Interesting pick. I'm going to start off with my Weavile. And level is only level 30 33, if I'm reading my screen correctly. It's kind of at my looking at my TV from an angle here. Thought I read like 31 for a second, but I actually read 33. But I'm going to hit it with Avalanche and probably end it like that. But it's going to use Feint on me. A move that can actually get past Protect. But it's no match for my Avalanche. I gotta bring out a Graveler, okay. I'm banking on this guy having Sturdy, so I'm just gonna use False Swipe. And then I'm gonna finish it off with Avalanche. I get hit with Bulldoze, and it's gonna take a hit to my speed, but it should be able to go down with Avalanche. Weird. Graveler's actually outspeeding me. And Graveler's not that fast of a Pokemon, and Weavile's supposed to be one of the quicker ones out there. I wonder what's going on. I'm hoping this is not a sign of things to come, because Weavile, I think, has a very high speed rating. I just want to check it real quick. My speed rating for Weavile is 195. So that should be more than sufficient to take on a Graveler. Anyway, you got a Staraptor now. Unless there was something up with that Graveler that I do not know about. Or if he was using, like, priority moves, which I could be a possibility, but I don't know. He's going to use Aerial Ace on me, and I'm going to hit it with Avalanche. Really, how am I getting outsped by a Pokemon half my level and with a speed rating of almost 200? Huh, so much skill for one so young. Like I said, I hope it's not a sign of things to come, but yeah, he went down pretty quickly. So yeah, I actually need strength here to get some of these items, so let's go ahead and do that. Got an Earth Plate, another Arceus Plate, nice. Alright, and I'm going to need to use Rock Smash to break this one. So I can go ahead and push this rock to the left. Go up here and claim TM01 Focus Punch. Kind of a tricky move to use. You start by tightening your focus, and if you can go through the whole round without taking damage, you'll then unleash the attack. But if you at any point take damage during that turn, then it's essentially going to basically make you flinch and make you lose your turn. Do you see the slanted rocks in the ground? Feels awesome taking those faster than a bike. Yeah, it does, but I'm not here to do parkour with my bike. I am here to, I've done what I came to do, and now I'm getting out of here. Alright. And I also do want to go to Mount Coronet, because I think there's a lot of parts of Mount Coronet that I haven't looked at yet. Okay, I want to make sure I still had a Repel in play, and I do, so. Alright. And as a matter of fact, Mount Coronet's not too far from here. Let me get on my bike and go. And we'll just head up there. And I think it's the upper area that we want to go to because we actually needed Rock Climb for it. Alright, so let me go ahead and get around here. Make sure I don't fall from that ledge. So that'd be very disappointing because I have to work my way all the way back around. And now we can go up here. Since we have Rock Climb. Now, I am looking at a map, so this way I can find out exactly what I'm going to be running into. Although I may have come this way, I think, at least once. And we'll keep using this stuff. Again, I don't know how much of this place I have actually already explored. I mean, I think I have done a couple. I think I'm actually going to go this way. And go further in. this way. I guess I have been here. I'm right now just basically just trying to cover all my bases here. On here. It's been a while since I've been here. I've got to re-get my bearings. Now, I think there's anything in here that. Now, looks like I got all this stuff here. I guess I explored more Mount Coronet than I thought I did, but I know I didn't, go through here because I didn't have waterfall. I had to be Vulgner to earn the ability to use waterfall. And I think there's something up here that we couldn't get. Let's see what it is. And this rock is a stone plate, another Arceus plate, the rock type one. When the universe was created, shards became this plate. Now I know there's a few plates I can't get right now until like the post game. I'm gonna see if I can maybe find them all. I think I found about maybe half of them right now. Now, is there anything more I can do here? I don't think so, so I'm gonna go ahead and jet out of here. Now, if I go the other way. I think actually, this is probably gonna send me back. I think I may have already, although I think I may have missed something at Spear Pillar, now that I think about it, after I caught, Dialga. But knowing me, I got to, make sure I've covered all my bases and obviously get, content here. Still trying to do 30-minute episodes. Hell's on. This is gonna be tough finding these rocks in this weather. I think I have to go this way. Actually doing this from memory now. It's actually been about a week since I recorded episode 51. I went a few days without recording, taking a break from it, getting back to Pokemon Unite. Got back to Ultra Rank, by the way. Okay. I think this is going to take me to Spear Pillar. Now, is there something I forgot up here? Yes, there was. The Adamant Orb. And I think if you were playing, Shining Pearl, that would be the Lustrous Orb. Now, just to show you what this item is all about, let me go ahead and find it. A brightly gleaming orb to be held by Dialga. It boosts the power of dragon and steel type moves when it's held. So this, if I were to ever use Dialga in battle, I would be giving it that orb to take its power even higher than it already is. Alright, I don't think I'm going to use another repel. I think I have an escape rope in here. And then I'm just going to go ahead and get out of here. Yeah, I got 10 escape ropes. Let me get out of here. Alright. I'll go ahead and, did anything come about in this honey tree? I guess not. If it did, it's probably long gone, because it's been ages since I've actually even checked the honey trees. To tell you the truth, I don't think I ever did, to be honest with you. any chance I went, I got, I went ahead and put the honey on, but never really checked them. And I think what I'm also going to do now is hit Veilstone City real quick. I'm going to swing by the department store. I want to look at their TM department, see if there's maybe any last, any other suggestions I could probably think of for my move sets. Even though I think I'm pretty much set in stone about what I'm going to be using. I need to get to Veilstone. Veilstone is over here. Go ahead and have a quick gander at the TM department. Maybe I'll pick up a few pedestals with the cash I have left as well. Want to go to the third floor, okay. Okay, third floor, please. I might as well have a few on hand just in case I decide to train more Pokemon. And I'll know what I'm going to be expecting at the end game here. Actually, before we do anything, any goodies I can sell? Get rid of these pearls. I still haven't cashed in that Helix Fossil. Alright. I'm not going to get rid of any of these. I got about 145,000 to spend here. Let's see. I'll grab one more. I want to see if I can get at least one of each of these TMs, if I don't already have at least one. I'm not even really looking at the, what moves they are, but just so I have them. And it's nice that they have all these TMs at the ready, and they're relatively cheap because for those who want to do competitive battling, they're always putzing around with the move sets and all that. And fortunately, it's not like Sword and Shield, where the TMs, where basically all the TMs are indefinite use. And instead, they introduce what are called TRs, which are the one-time uses, and they're more lower-level moves, but you can find TRs so easily in Sword and Shield that it's almost impossible to not be able to find the perfect moveset for your Pokemon. And get a do it relatively cheaply as well. Alright, Blizzard there. Again, it's only if I don't have it that I'm going to buy it. I think one of the things I did in one of the generations, I think it was Gen 6 or so, was when I went on a personal mission. That was actually Gen 7 now that I think about Sun and Moon. That I went on a personal mission to find all the TMs in the game, which I eventually did. It took a while, but found all 100 TMs that were out there. Because in Sun and Moon, those TMs are also indefinite use as well. They didn't have HMs in that game. They relied on wild Pokemon in order to get you from point A to point B and vice and everything. So you actually need to teach your Pokemon the TM, the HM moves. I'll just buy one of each of these pedestals. I still haven't done anything else to my secret base. I've kind of forgotten where that is, to be fully honest with you. I don't know if these change every day or not. I've got all this money, I might as well put it to use. I'll eventually use these, I guess. Alright, well, that's not gonna get much out of him. Alright, so do a quick once over of my Pokemon. first things first, though, I want to go ahead and fly back to the Pokemon League. Thankfully, I don't have to do Victory Road again. I spent enough time in that place as it was, doing all that grinding. You think it would have been better to go to the Grand Underground to battle because the levels are higher? Not necessarily. I mean, these guys are giving me a good 1,500, 1,600 experience a pop. Especially if you're fighting evolved and heavier Pokemon, I believe is the key to getting a lot of experience quickly. And thankfully, we have this permanent experience share. Being able to reduce the grinding by a significant amount, because I probably would have spent a lot more than 3 hours grinding to be ready for this endgame here. Now, I think there's actually one last bit of business I have to attend to. And here he comes. Hold it. Don't go off without me. You're challenging the Pokemon League, aren't you? That's why I'm here, too. Let's see who's more worthy of making the challenge with a battle. All right, Barry. You better bring your A-game, because I sure as heck going to bring mine. You're bringing in a full team of six. Excellent. Going to start with a Staraptor, though? I guess I'll start off with my Weavile, then. Let's see what levels you are bringing here. So you're going to start off, we'll put the pressure on him. Unfortunately, my Intimidate is going to kick in. Your Staraptor is at level 49, so I've got a bit of an edge on you. Hate to say it, but I think Avalanche is going to put you away. Oh, you can use close combat. A beautiful counter to Weavile. Okay, Barry. Okay. You want to play hardball, huh? Wasn't expecting that. But that was a very wise move there. Maybe I'll try Garchomp, have him use his new Rock Slide. That also makes me more concerned. Is it just because Staraptor is incredibly quick? Or we're getting incredibly unlucky with the speed on Weavile? Oh, I had a Focus Sash on. Oh, cute. Well, then I'll just hit you with Dragon Claw. And it's going to pull Staraptor with 1 HP. Going to bring in Empoleon, his ace. The fully evolved Piplup, now a water steel type. And unfortunately, Dragon Claw's not going to do much. And, but I think Brick Break would be perfect for this. He's got a Quick Claw. It's going to use Flash Cannon. Interesting move. That's a steel type move. Not expecting that to do a lot of damage. Here comes Brick Break. Puts Empoleon away. So his ace has already gone down. Alright. Bringing in Rapidash. Alright, let's switch things up a bit. Bring in Gyarados. So he's been draining a Ponyta. Yeah, that's not my favorite animation for the stickers. I was trying to really give him a good one, and I think it was very tough to get the water one the way I wanted it to. Anyway, I think Waterfall should be enough to put him away. He's going to try Poison Jab. A fire Pokemon that knows poison. I thought that was Magmar's department. And I'm pretty sure Magmar's in this game, because he does have an evolution that debuted in Gen 4. It was Magmortar. Haven't seen him yet, though. Maybe not until National Dex. Alright, Garchomp hits level 61. Next up is Heracross, Bug Fighting, and I think this is going to be perfect for Crobat. Alright, let's just finish him off with a quick Aerial Ace. Heracross is one of my favorite Pokemon out there, I will say that, but it goes down like a ton of bricks to flying. Bug fighting type, double weakness. And now you're going to bring in Roserade. You got a Roserade of your own, so you know what? You brought your ace out, how about I bring my ace out? Infernape, it's your turn. I'm trying to give everybody a chance here. Alright, Flamethrower. there. Awesome. So now we got momentum on our side. And now he's got a Snorlax. This guy may actually put up a bit of... Well, you know what? Infernape, I'm going to need your close combat. It's a normal type with a lot of HP and a lot of defense. Let's see what close combat can do with this guy. His Munchlax obviously evolved. Bringing in the heavy artillery there. Half a ton of them. But one bit of close combat was all we needed. And down goes Snorlax. I guess it's true. The bigger they are, the harder they fall. And my Roserade's going to get a level up out of it. And all he has left is Staraptor, who's got 1 HP, if I'm not mistaken. You know what? My Roserade hasn't been in battle yet. I know it's got the type disadvantage here. But if Staraptor's only got 1 HP, I think it should still go down pretty quickly. I fully believe in this last one. I have no reason to freak out. He's got 1 HP, Barry. You better be freaking out. You are literally down to your last hit point here. Antigone's not going to really help you much. We're not finished yet. We'll get out of this spot because we're so tight. Well, you're in about as big of a hole, deep of a hole as you can get here. I just need one attack and you're done. Use Dazzling Gleam. And that's it. That is all she wrote. Roserade finishes the deal. And we have defeated Barry, his ace team. What just went down? My team still needs raising? Well, compared to my team, yes. I guess I'm not ready for the Pokemon League if I'm losing to you. Darn it. Just you wait. I'll get tougher and win my way through the Pokemon League. Because I'm going to be the toughest Pokemon trainer there is. The champion. T.U.G, you better not lose to anyone before me. Well, I haven't lost to anybody yet, and I don't plan on losing now. So, gotta heal though. So Barry actually put up a bit of a fight. Caught me with a couple of trick moves right out of the gate. But once his bag of tricks ran out, I got the momentum on my side, and that was it. So we'll go ahead and talk to this guy now. Let me confirm that you're qualified to challenge the Pokemon League. Well, I've got 8 badges. I should be good. To do so, I'll need to examine the gym badges you gathered from around Sinnoh. Orberg City's Coal Badge, Eterna City's Forest Badge, Veilstone City's Cobble Badge, Pistoria City's Fen Badge, Hardhome City's Relic Badge, Canalave City's Mine Badge, Snowpoint City's Icicle Badge, and finally Sunny Shore City's Beacon Badge. We have qualified for the Pokemon League. Very well. Trainer, you've indeed collected all the gym badges of Sinnoh. Demonstrate the power that brought you here and go for glory. I definitely plan to do that in the next episode. Let me just go ahead and restock up. I just want to check on my inventory here. Got plenty of hyper potions, 2 max potions, full restores, plenty of those, revives. And I got some full heals, plenty of those, so... Yeah, I'm good. Alright, so at this point, I'm going to go ahead and call it quits here. And in the next episode, we will challenge the Elite Four. Because we have the toughest battles in the game ahead of us. So, hopefully all this grinding will have paid off. Until next time, when we battle the Elite Four, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.